So, enabling modern apps, reimagining the application lifecycle. So basically, what I wanted to show people out of this slide is, if you look down the bottom here, okay, so we can see down the bottom we have Windows Azure, Windows Server, and System Center 2012. Okay, this is Microsoft story. This is the new family, okay, on the right-hand side. LinkedIn with Visual Studio, .NET, and HTML5. Can I use Visual Studio? No. Can I code .NET? No. Can I code HTML5? No. Do I want to? No. But I will need to know about it. Well, if I want to know about everything in our environment, particularly take an ergo, considering I said we have a dev team, so as part of the System Center practice, we have to look after our own internal private cloud and public cloud for our own staff. We've the guts of 200 staff there, so it's a reasonably sized network. And, you know, I need to be able to tell. We had the conversation earlier where, you know, someone says it's not the app, or it's not this, it's the network, or it's not that, it's the SAN, whatever. I need to be able to tell whose problem it is or where the issue lies. It doesn't matter if it's with my team or with someone else's team. You know, we just need to be able to get to the bottom of it quickly. And, you know, System Center, Windows Azure, Windows Server, Visual Studio, all of these components now have very, very tight integrations with each other that will allow you to deliver that seamless management across the stack, if you so wish. You don't. I'm not trying to say, you know what, everyone has to go out and ramp up on Visual Studio now, or .NET, or HTML5. However, if you have environments like that in your own business, then we can now start linking them in. So we spoke briefly about DevOps earlier, and I'll explain this. So DevOps, so this is a team that Microsoft have been publicly kind of talking about for the last few years. Dave mentioned, how long ago did you?
2002.
Dave started hearing about 2002. So DevOps, for me, has been the last few years, you know, in the public domain, and particularly around the System Center and the Windows Server. And DevOps is essentially, if you have a look here at this, we've got our developer on the left, and we've got our operations admin on the right. And, you know, typically there's this wall here where it's like, code, that's them. Infrastructure, that's us, and leave it like that. So what Microsoft have done with System Center and Windows Server 2012 is that they brought the two products or two offerings, if you like, together. So you can share, you know, the dev team can share their code, if you like, without you having to know about it. And you know, if for example in Ops Manager, we have the application performance monitoring feature looking at a particular application, and it raises an issue with some code. Grant, we haven't got a clue what that code is. You know, we just know that code is causing, you know, 90% utilization on that particular web page when the end user is logging onto it. So instead of us going and printing out screens or dragging a developer over and having a look at our System Center console, where, you know, that would be possibly as unfamiliar to them as the likes of Visual Studio or Team Foundation Server is to us, then what we can do with the integration is we can actually attach the alert code into TFS and Visual Studio and quite easily just send that over to the developer, who can then fire that up in an environment that they're comfortable with, and they can have a look at it and say, Grant, that's how I troubleshoot the problem. And if needs be, they can edit the code and then send it back over through System Center to, if there was a ticket raised, they can close off the ticket, and then they can make sure that the alert itself is managed. So it's kind of, it's looking after the whole application lifecycle. And, you know, another acronym that's been doing the rounds a few years is ALM. So it's Application Lifecycle Management. And that's essentially the message that Microsoft and other vendors, not just Microsoft, but Microsoft are, in my view, one of the main the leaders, if you like, of this kind of movement at the moment. But so with ALM, they're also talking about taking the application from its conception or from its initial development all the way through to its management, to that end user who picks up a phone and, you know, uses the company line of business app, or, you know, uses whatever it is on their phone or their smart on their tablet or whatever. And, you know, it just brings centralization and a better sharing of resources within the organization together. So that was something that's definitely been doing the rounds, if you like. So I mentioned some case studies at the keynote. So there was, I think there's probably about four or five, and I definitely would encourage people to review the video from the URL at the start of this slide, or the start of this particular section in the deck. So this was pretty amazing for me. Looking at this, and, you know, we as a non-Microsoft employee, yes, I'm pro Hyper-V. I've never kind of worked as I've never deployed VMware. I work a lot with VMware because you know System Center and Ops Manager and stuff like that, and a huge majority of our customers would have VMware. The bigger the customer, typically, you know, the more likely it is that they're going to have VMware. Hopefully that'll change. However, Microsoft rolled out this year Domino's Pizza as one of their case studies. Who, you know, when they have a case study, it's gone on record. There's a white paper there. You know, they're pretty much standing up and they're saying, "Yeah, we back this 100%." And Domino's Pizza moved from the other guys, i.e. VMware, over to Hyper-V 2012. So they had some stats here, and I just took this from them from the original kind of slides. So on an average day, Domino's sells 1 million pizzas worldwide. One third of its business, and this is critical for systems management, one third of its business, which is more than $1 billion in 2012, is done online, which means that there's systems there for them to have to manage, their internal IT guys to have to manage. So what they did was, they had their VMware environment. They had a huge number of calls coming into the help desk. They were inundated with, you know, issues. Now, it may well have been to do with application level as well, of course, but their time to resolution, or mean time to resolution on tickets that were logged was crazy. Now, before I go too deep into it, they only have two guys running this administration. This IT administration. And that's not a fail, because when we heard it first, we kind of thought, well, two guys running it, you know, there's your problem. However, they used to have more. But the reason they now have two is because they've deployed Windows Server 2012 Hyper-V. They've rolled out two hosts, two physical hosts to every store across the US, okay, 5,000 stores approximately in the US. And those hosts are not clustered, as in they don't have shared storage, so they're using Hyper-V replica. Okay, and of course for maintenance they can use shared nothing live migration, as the guys demonstrated earlier on today and we spoke about yesterday. And they've got one virtual machine which runs their POS system on each site. Okay, so Windows Server 2012 and System Center 2012 SP1 Service Pack 1 manages that across the US for Domino's Pizza. And you can see here, help desk calls have dropped by 99%. There was one point which I didn't think too relevant to put up here, but on the have a guess what the busiest day would be. Dave mentioned two, I only heard one at the keynote, but the busiest day of the year for Domino's Pizza. And Thanksgiving is one, yeah, and Super Bowl Sunday, yeah. So they did something like, I can't recall the number, I think they said something like 15 million slices of pizza on each of those days or something crazy like that, you know. And to have System Center managing that and to have a company of that size kind of stand up there on the stage at MMS and essentially say, we're putting our fate in Hyper-V and Windows Server 2012, you know, that's a massive coup for Microsoft. And for me as a consultant and someone that, you know, I'm talking to enterprise customers, not too many of them are that size, probably I don't think I have any that are that size, of one or two. But you know, to talk to customers like that and say, look, here's a validated case study for Windows Server 2012 and System Center, it's a massive boost. Another one, and this particular case study caught my eye. I saw this a white paper on this a good few months ago, and it's something that caught my eye. I don't normally deal with the client and device management, as in the config manager and the stuff that John's going to do, but it caught my eye because of the innovation and the thought behind it. So Toyota have engaged with Microsoft, well, a Microsoft partner, to solve a problem that they had across Europe. So they had 3,500 computers basically based in each dealership across Europe. And none of those computers were connected to the main Toyota network because they're standalone dealers, okay? However, each of those computers needed to get certain updates for the main application that Toyota used to update their systems and their sales and whatever their application is. So to get around the problem of, you know, sending out USB disks or, you know, telling people to go to a particular drive on the internet or whatever and log down or download a zip file, what Microsoft and the partner did was they went out and they deployed System Center Configuration Manager in-house in the HQ in Toyota. And then they went and they used Windows Intune. So, John, are you doing a bit on Intune tomorrow? Or?
Tomorrow? I'm not doing it.
Or, sorry, today. Presenting all week. Yeah. Okay, cool. So John will talk a little bit more about Intune. But Intune is basically client device management from the cloud. So Intune looked at each of those 3,500 computers and basically ran patch management, antivirus, and of course application packaging across each of the devices, and brought that centralization right the way back into Toyota HQ. So I thought really neat use case there for System Center on the client and device management side.